welcome to the Big Fat Quiz of the Year 2015. The Big Fat Quiz captures the true meaning of Christmas by forcing six people to sit together, playing a game and pretending to like each other. If you haven't seen the Big Fat Quiz before, let me put it into the Star Wars universe for you. Essentially, an alliance of panellists are pitted against an evil Sith Lord, that's me, and at some point, someone accidentally gets off with their sister. This is the quiz that looks back at the biggest stories of the last year, realises they're a bit terroristy, and picks some nicer ones to quiz about. Not talking about any of that. Let's move on. Well, let's meet the teams. First up, two of the youngest, coolest, hippest comedians in the country couldn't make it this evening, so instead we've got Rob Brydon and Joe Brand. He's the swat of the class who's finally realised his dream of hanging out with the teacher. It's Richard Iowati and Greg Davis. And finally, she's beautiful, charming and a joy to be around, and he's around. It's Claudia Winkleman and David Mitchell. Nice. So, Rob Brydon, you performed this year with Sir Tom Jones. They say never meet your heroes. How did Tom cope with it?
He was taking in his stride, Jimmy. He's a professional. He was a little bit nervous, but, you know, that's not unusual.
Rob Brydon, everyone. Thank you very much. Joe, how's your year been?
Shit.
OK.
I've been on tour, I've got a divorce, I've killed a tortoise, you know, lots of things. One of those isn't true, I didn't get a divorce.
You killed a tortoise?
Well, not personally.
Well, what do you mean? A tortoise died during the year and you blame yourself?
When I was teaching, there was a kid in my class who was inconsolable one day because his pet tortoise had died, and like he couldn't stop crying, and he had to be sent home in the end. And the next day he came in, and he was absolutely fine. And I went, are you all right today? He goes, yeah, I'm all right today. And I went, oh, good, I'm glad to hear that. Did you bury him? He goes, oh, no, my dad hollowed him out. We use him as an ashtray. Scooped him out with a spoon.
So, Greg, you used to be a teacher, so surely you're going to win the quiz, aren't you?
Oh, gosh, no. I was a drama teacher anyway. How hard's that? Make up a play, see you in an hour.
Now, Richard, you've been travelling the world for the whole year, haven't you, for Travel Man?
Oh, right. Yeah, prior to that, I've been Peckham-based. But,
so Peckham and then the world?
Yeah, a lot of places that are a short haul. One with Greg to Moscow.
You two went to Moscow?
Yep.
Yeah.
Have the other teams gone away together? Have you...?
Yeah.
I went away with Richard as well.
Yeah.
What?
I'm starting a cult. You will receive a call in the night and you come away with me and you come back with new ideas.
So, Claudia, you're used to the glamour and glitz of Strictly, obviously.
Talk
me through David's outfit this evening.
It's perfect. It would be very good for a tango.
If we were filming it in black and white, yeah, I'd agree.
What's wrong with it?
He looks
Jimmy?
Perfect.
Just saying, it's not as glitzy as I'm used to seeing Claudia surrounded by people in sort of, you know, sparkles.
Tiny little things, fluorescent feathers.
It would be totally inappropriate if I turned up. If I turned up as you suggest you wanted, in feathers and a little fluorescent bikini, you'd have taken the piss even more than you have out of my grey shirt. You know, I can't win.
Can we get on with the quiz? Let's remind ourselves of this year's headlines. 2015 was the hottest year on record. People were warned to avoid any physical exertion, which explains the performances of the England rugby team, Chelsea FC, and my girlfriend. UKIP leader Nigel Farage failed to win a parliamentary seat. Farage is often described as a man of the people, and those people are bigoted assholes. Oscar Pistorius was found guilty of murder a few weeks after being released from prison and put under house arrest. He's in a house. It's where he's most dangerous. OK, wouldn't be a quiz without questions. Eyes down. For our first question, it's over to the legend that is Quentin Tarantino.
Hi, Jimmy. This year, the British press became obsessed with something that could have come straight out of one of my movies. And the names Mr. Ginger, Mr. Strong, the Tall Man, the Old Man, the Gent, and Mr. Montana were everywhere. But can your teams tell me what they'd done?
Oh! Very well done.
Thank you.
Claudia, can we play poker at some stage? Because it feels like you're not holding anything back there.
I was excited.
Next question. This year, Dr. Walter Palmer from Minnesota did something that led him to become the most hated man in the world. What did he do?
Oh, of course. You are a genius. Yes, right.
Right, it now.
He knows everything. I know nothing.
I know, I'm just saying I'm not receiving the same level of support at this table.
That's because I've answered both of the questions so far.
Greg, I'm not flourishing in this relationship. I'm not flourishing, I don't feel valued.
You want me to answer the questions and then praise you?
Yes, please.
OK.
That's how my marriage works.
OK.
Yeah, yes, I would like that.
Well, well done for answering those two questions.
Thank you. Thank you.
Internally.
Thank you.
For our next question, the children of Mitchellbrook Primary School have once again put on one of their spectacular school plays. But what news story are they acting out?
This car is really fast.
This car is really slow.
I like cars.
Really, that's a wrap.
I'm hungry. Get me some food.
Could I have some hot food, please?
Sorry, but we're closed.
Uh-oh. There's no hot food.
Kids. That's why I'm here, to watch them.
It's a properly good school play. That's what a decent drama teacher does, Greg. Yeah. I hope you've learned something. Are they there?
Are they here?
You're the drama teachers from Mitchellbrook? You're not the drama teachers, you're proper teachers.
Yes. What do you teach? Primary? It's not teaching, it's colouring in, mate.
I want to know what news story were they acting out there? I mean...
This is major.
Oh, wow. Mm.
You can't fit it all in.
I can't.
Sorry, David and Claudia are also voicing an adult film while we're doing the quiz.
My fax machine's broken. I haven't seen any of that.
There we go.
Well done.
I've answered at tedious length. Tedious length is my porn name.
In September, there was a very small story. I'm not sure if you heard about it, but the Prime Minister allegedly put his gentleman junk into the mouth of a dead pig. My question is this. Why on earth did he allegedly do it?
I'm not as familiar with these practices as some in the London sect, but,
yeah, you always get left out of the pig-fucking parties, don't you?
Yeah. I suppose sheep's more your thing, is it?
Yeah. Just
saying. What? Yeah.
You're going to start making sheep references.
I'm just saying, when I asked you how many sexual partners you'd had, you started to count and you fell asleep. That's all I'm saying.
You've done this to me before. You started making buying noises. Don't do that.
You.
Don't do that. It's very hard for me to concentrate with an erection.
OK, take a look at this clip of Ed Miliband's resignation speech after this year's general election.
Thank you for the selfies. Thank you for the support. And thank you for the most unlikely cult of the 21st century.
Yes.
That is cult. C-U-L-T. What I want to know is, what was the most unlikely cult of the 21st century? Most unlikely cult. Have you all got something?
Yeah.
We've knocked this out of the park.
Have you? What, you ready for answers?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go to the answers. Okay, so Quentin Tarantino asked you what Mr. Ginger, Mr. Strong, the tall man, the old man, the gent and Mr. Montana had done. What did you all think?
The answer is the Hatton Garden heist. Men of advanced years managed to break in through thick wall, and they got in and they stole all the stuff from safety deposit boxes, and it had all the hallmarks of a Hollywood film.
I don't think it had quite all the hallmarks, did it? Because they used their bus passes to get there on the bus.
They did, didn't they?
How old was the getaway driver? Because normally getaway driving, you imagine someone skidding off at high speed.
I think there were skid marks.
Well, you all got this right. They were all suspects in the Hatton Garden heist.
All right.
There you go,
well done. Well done, everyone.
Okay, next up, I asked you how Dr. Walter Palmer became the most hated man in the world. What did you put?
Well, he shot a lion called Cecil.
Yeah.
And the guy said in his defence, he said, oh, do you know what? I didn't know he was a beloved lion. So you're going to shoot them based on their personality and how popular they are amongst their peer group. Awful. And he was a dentist.
Yeah.
Just gets worse.
Are your existing teeth behind those, or do they take them out?
I've no idea. All I know is I have to dip these when I drive at night.
What do you dip them in? Like jam.
Yeah, why not?
Cecil was already depressed before he was shot by a dentist because he was called Cecil. He found that out with his last breath. I'm called what? He thought he was called Barabbas, King of the Plain.
Claudia Davis, did you get this?
We read it out as well, do we?
Well, yeah, as
okay,
well.
Okay,
yeah.
He shot a lion called Cecil. Full stop. I put a full stop in.
It's important.
Wasn't required with the Hatton Garden heist because that's not a sentence. But he shot a. That's a sentence, got a verb.
Okay, points all round. Marvin.
Lovely.
Next up, the children of Mitchellbrook Primary School were acting out a news story. What did you think it was?
I've written a short essay.
The event surrounding the non-renewal of Jeremy Clarkson's contract.
But he doesn't really touch on what those events were, which, to my mind, calls into question the validity of the answer as an answer. He's very much sketching around the issue.
If you think that's not a complete answer, wait until you hear Richard and Greg's. What have you gone with?
Well, did Clarkson and then really just a kind of an oblong, I guess.
Jimmy, I'm all for this anarchic sense of fun. I love that the audience are laughing at it. But please don't go giving points for this kind of nonsense, OK? Take a look at this. Clarkson punch says it all.
I don't
beautifully
see why
written.
The punch was evident in the dramatisation. No. A lot of people think he was sacked for it. He wasn't.
Yes.
They just didn't renew his contract.
Yes, correct. I'm aware of that.
Yeah, well, exactly.
But I was looking for brevity and levity in my answer.
Well, at the risk of upsetting you, Rob, Joe, points all round.
Yes.
Points all round, surely. That's what it is. That's what we were getting at. Right. Next, I asked you why on earth David Cameron allegedly put his penis in a pig's mouth. What do you think?
The answer is peer pressure.
Good answer.
It's worrying in a prime minister.
It shouldn't have been a story, really. It's about owning your own gossip, I think. I, for example, very early on in my comedy career, went on record to say that I, as a pubescent man, I enjoyed relations with a large blue teddy bear at my house. I put that on record, and therefore it's not a story anymore. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, it didn't even look like a bear. It was so badly made. I didn't really know what I was having sex with, if I'm honest.
You should have said it in the beginning of his career, when he was first elected as leader of the Conservative Party in his opening speech. Thanks very much, everyone.
Just
there's
so
one
you know.
Thing you need to know about me. You'll never guess what I once did.
But as I said, I think it would be better if it was a thing he did regularly rather than as a one-off peer pressure event. If he just went, this is my jam. I like doing this, it relaxes me.
It makes me a better Prime Minister.
And I'm going to keep doing this. And I'm going to keep doing this into a third term.
OK, so, Claudia, David, what did you put?
We put an initiation ritual at Oxford for a posh dining society.
Well, that is the right answer. You had the name of the society?
Yeah.
It was allegedly an initiation ceremony for an Oxford dining society, the Piers Gaveston. OK, final answer in this round. I asked you what Ed Miliband described as the most unlikely cult of the 21st century. What did you think?
These are Millie fans. He said that he said there was a new type of follower. Wanted to meet him and have the photo
They were in love
with him.
They suddenly fancied him.
It was a sexy thing.
Yeah.
Oh, it was a sexy
thing? It's a sexy thing.
Really?
They wanted to rub themselves against him.
So did you get... You got this?
Yes, yeah, we put Millie fandom.
We put Millie fandom as well.
So, I've got some footage of the Millie fans. Let's take a look at the attention he was getting.
That's me and Tess.
OK, points all round.
You're marking us down for peer pressure, is the answer.
Well, marking you down, you mean not giving you the... Well,
why?
Well, because it makes it easier, so the ticks and the crosses.
I'm with them. That's the right answer.
Thank you. Thank you.
In fact, theirs is the most intelligent answer we've had all night, because they've got to the nub of the matter.
Yeah.
It was peer pressure.
Well, you make a very interesting point, but you're not actually in charge, so...
Isn't it fascinating that Richard and Greg, two of the finest minds in this studio, certainly, perhaps not beyond, but in this studio, have taken the level of this show somewhere else. They've not been content to settle for glibness. Mm. They've not gone for laughs. That's been very clear. Yes. they're going for something deeper.
Yes.
I say you refuse that point at your peril.
I agree.
Happy to take you all on.
Are you going to give us the point?
No.
Why?
Because this is about humanity.
It's about the integrity. It's about the integrity of the entire quiz, Jimmy.
Yeah.
Jimmy, Britain is a democracy. There are six people here all saying to you, give them the point.
Let's just say, in a future question, we'll both deliberately answer wrong. You can answer correctly.
That's lovely.
Yes, we will. Thank you. Yes, we will do
that. I'm sorry, there's not a Malaysian betting syndicate involved in this, is there?
And neither is it a totalitarian state presided over by you.
You've lost our trust.
This quiz absolutely is that.
No.
Not anymore. No. Not anymore. Democracy. Yeah. Democracy.
Thank you.
We're doing a quiz and there's going to be a winner and there's going to be a loser and we'll rig it if we need to. Right. It's not a democracy and no one's here to have fun. This is Christmas. It's a quiz.
What do you win, just to be clear?
Pig's head. OK, so at the end of that round, the scores are Rob and Joe have 5, Claudia and David have 5, Richard and Greg have 4, because they got one wrong. Plenty more quiz to come. See you after the break. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz of the Year. The next round is all about the music of 2015. Naked images of Justin Bieber hit the internet. Not the first time I've seen a photo of Justin Bieber and thought, what a dick. On Adele's first single for 3 years, she sings, I must have called 1,000 times. I assume the next line is, have you been missold PPI? To celebrate his 3 sell-out Wembley shows, Ed Sheeran had a huge lion tattooed on his chest. It seemed like a good idea at the time, until he was gunned down by a dentist. Right, time for some more questions. It's the music round, David.
I'm worried about that.
What, it being the music round?
Yeah.
No, you were David Mitchell, you haven't got a problem. OK, for our first question, I want you to take a look at this clip of some people who are a bit down in the dumps. My question is simple. Why are they so upset? Take a look.
stop crying.
It's not funny. I want to press the button so hard and rewind back like 3 years ago.
I'm not to apologize. I'm fucking dirty. Piece of shit.
Why were they filming that?
Why? Because they were very sad.
No, it's because they're towering narcissists.
He films everything now. If it's not filmed, it's not happening.
Can I just say I'm slightly perturbed by seeing my husband at the end? I had no idea.
Okay, so you all got something there? All right, for our next question, it's over to the one and only Jon Snow. He's reporting on one of the biggest songs of the year, but what is it? Over to you, Jon.
In an unprecedented legal case, a 29-year-old Canadian man has sued his ex-partner for emotional distress after she ceased contacting him on his cell phone. The man told the court that she had previously placed regular nightly calls to him, calls that could only mean one thing. But since he'd left the city, all communication had been terminated. The prosecution alleged that the lack of calls had left the man down and stressed out, and that all he does these days is wonder if his former girlfriend is bending over backwards or indeed rolling up a backwards for someone else. Taking the stand, the plaintiff summed up his case, explaining, "You used to call me on my... You used to... Yeah." Thank you, Jimmy.
Why don't we get this answer?
Yes, yeah.
Incorrect.
Let's deliberately...
Yeah, we don't know this, so let's both deliberately get it wrong. Take the power away from the man.
Thank you.
And get everything back.
Give them the point.
Yeah,
thanks.
Okay.
Thanks, great.
That assumes we know the answer to this.
Do you not know the answer?
It's borderline. I think there's going to be quibble over this.
Quibble?
Quibble.
There'll be no quibble. I mean, if you got it right, you got it right.
Well, that's happened before.
All right, so next up, Kanye West headlined the Pyramid Stage at Glastonbury with a rather divisive performance. What I want to know is, what did he describe himself as during his set? So he described himself on stage.
Biggest rock star in the world.
For our next question, it's over to X Factor judge Rita Ora. Rita Ora, David. You know.
Wow!
Hiya, Jimmy, how are you? Now, life as a pop star can be tough. And my mate Enrique Iglesias ended up in hospital recently by having a bizarre accident on stage. But what happened?
He had an... I know this.
Well, I mean, that's very much how this works. And finally, in March, Jay-Z and a host of his celebrity pals...
Oh, yes.
Jay-Z, yes. A host of his celebrity pals, Jay-Z's pals, the other letters, F and X. Yeah. Well, I'd say JZ myself, but, you know. Not to his face.
Did you spend a lot of time with him?
No.
Fair enough.
Well, I don't know, actually, because I don't know who he is.
That's ironic. When I saw David in makeup earlier, I said, "How are you?" And he said, "I'm photoshoot fresh, looking like wealth. I'm about to call the paparazzi on myself," which is a Jay-Z lyric.
I did say.
Finally, in March, Jay-Z and a host of his celebrity pals launched a music streaming service this year that promised to be a moment that will forever change the course of music history. Can you remember what it was called?
Well, I got...
Yes.
Oh, you do? Good.
When Richard and I were in Russia together, Richard did an incredible impression of Roland Dorsabel from Tears for Fears.
Yeah.
He genuinely did. I suspect the chance of him replicating it now are minimal, but I just thought I'd say I saw it. It was incredible.
Richard, please.
I'll pick a moment later on, and if it's as good as Greg says, we'll all know what's happened. See, though, how I resisted peer pressure.
Mm. Yes.
Let's have some answers. First of all, I showed you a collection of grief-stricken fans. What did you think they were upset about?
They were very upset about the One Direction news. They were upset about changes to the status quo of One Direction.
No, yeah, but...
You've got to plump for one or the other.
I don't think you do. They were... This is the... Now, we see, we're back into it, aren't we? We're back into the process. You cannot say that this is not true. They are upset about changes to the status quo of One Direction. Point, please.
No. We're putting ourselves on the line and saying Zayn, they're specifically upset that Zayn Malik left the band.
Yes.
As was I.
That's our answer.
I've deliberately got the next question wrong to help you out. I can't believe this.
I've bitten the hand that feeds me, haven't I?
All right, well, I'll say it now. It was Zayn. It's because Zayn is leaving.
There
we are. David?
Yes, it's because Zayn is leaving One Direction.
Who's Zayn?
Zayn Malik.
What instrument did Zayn play?
The harpsichord.
The problem is...
Well, I think we've already covered One Direction now. OK, points all round there.
Points all round.
Oh.
Next up, you heard Jon Snow reporting on one of the biggest songs of the year. What did you think it was? Over to David Mitchell for the answer.
We deliberately didn't give the answer in order to make the previous round retrospectively fair on Richard and Greg.
I heart Jon Snow. What did you go for?
I went for Adele. We knew it was wrong. We didn't care. What are you going to do about it, Jimmy? Make me write it again? I don't think so. There's a new boss on this show.
If you built trust
too late early, for a comeback. Let's move on.
Deal. OK, Richard, Greg, what did you put?
The Drake song where he dances in various unfurnished white rooms.
That is the right answer.
Oh,
that's it. They got a point. We're back. We're back. Isn't this a lovely metaphor for a dystopian society that's got its act together? As a society, we said, hang on a minute, this isn't right.
Yeah.
Did we complain about it? Well, we did. But then... but then we put you, the government, in this instance, out of the equation. We said, let's fix it between us.
Rob, you didn't know the song.
Wouldn't it be lovely if Britain...
Drake's... Sorry, you were going to write down Drake Hotline Bling, were you?
I was going to write that down, direct line 24-hour insurance, is what I was going to say.
Let's take a look at Jon Snow.
Ever since I left the city, you.
Yeah, it was, of course, Drake's Hotline Bling. I asked you what title Kanye West gave himself while on stage in Glastonbury this year.
I could tell you the title I gave him. No, I won't. Because I'm not allowed to say it on the telly.
He said he was the biggest rock and roll star in the world.
What did you put for this one, David?
Greatest pop star in the world. We also know that the BBC had to put up subtitles for the very rude words, and there was a lot of Mother Ducker, which we like.
What did you go for, Richard and Greg?
Well, to get the point, we said that he was the biggest rock star in the world, but Richard also suggested that he was vulnerable. Vibrant at times.
And vulnerable, vibrant, and at times hostile when stressed.
I think everyone got that right, cold, pretty much. Let's take a look at his staggering claim at Glastonbury. Here he is performing under a massive lighting rig.
I'm going to say it tonight. You are now watching the greatest living rock star on the planet!
If you really make it big in music, I imagine you can get someone to do your own intro for you. You know, get someone off stage to go, now the greatest rock star in the world. But he's obviously a bit short of money, so he's going, ladies and gentlemen, the greatest rock star in the world. Hello, it's me!
Get it!
So our next answer, Rita Ora asked you how Enrique Iglesias ended up in hospital. What did you think?
Well, we knew this. This was there was a drone, one of these drone cameras. He reached up and, of course, the blade sliced quite literally through the skin of his hands, and it was bedlam. He reached down to his white T-shirt, because he looks great in white T-shirts, wrapped his hand, we went, oh, in hell, and he ran off into the wings. And that is a point.
That was a white T-shirt.
That was white before the accident, yes.
We said he played with a drone and his finger... well, not chopped off. That's when we slightly exaggerated, because I think it was just slightly owie.
It was, yeah. A bit owie is actually the technical medical
he
term.
He rendered his hand owie.
What did you guys think?
We thought he grabbed a drone as well. Yeah. And, in this day and age, how lovely to see a drone hitting entirely the correct target.
Nice. Yes, that's exactly what happened. He reached up to grab a drone with a camera on it and hurt his hand. And then he drew a heart with the blood on his T-shirt.
Really?
You know, yeah, there he is, like a maniac.
Oh, my word. Looks like Sylvester Stallone there. Yeah. Look at him.
Well, you all got that. Points all round.
Yeah.
Finally, I asked you what Jay-Z's music streaming service that was going to revolutionise music was called. What did you think?
Tidal. They wanted to make one which wasn't free because they don't have collectively enough money.
Richard, Greg, what did you think?
We thought it was called Tidal.
Yeah, and Rob, Joe?
Tidal Tunes.
Tidal Tunes.
If you don't give us a point, just because we tried to add to the entertainment of the evening, then more fool you, Jimmy, more fool you.
Points all round. Thank you. OK, let's see what that's done for the scores. Rob and Joe have 9, Richard and Greg have 9, Claudia and David have 9. Yeah. Time for Thank You, Greg. See you in a bit. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz of the Year. The next round is all about the last 12 months in television. Jeremy Clarkson was sacked by the BBC.
No, they didn't renew his contract.
Jeremy Clarkson failed to have his contract renewed by the BBC. His new show is going to be on Amazon Prime. The only problem is, if you're not in when it comes on, you have to watch it at the post office or around a neighbour's house. Katie Hopkins had a new TV show called If Katie Hopkins Ruled the World. But the only way I want to see Katie Hopkins on TV is if she's part of a People We Lost This Year montage. Well, let's remind ourselves of some of this year's TV highlights.
And now we're about to see a first jump from Joey Essex.
You think you are the king, and I am the blacksmith's boy. Please don't punch me. I wish you both well.
Am I tough enough? I'm tough enough? Hell yes, I'm tough enough.
Exterminate.
You certainly are a madman.
That's ingenious.
Gonna glove up.
Try and aim away from the dead man's face.
Nice bit of product placement for Next there.
First up, you saw Nigella Lawson there in her new series, Simply Nigella. But what did she cook? And I use that term very loosely. In the first episode, that left viewers rather underwhelmed.
Okay. I love that woman.
You love that woman?
I love... She's my favourite.
She's incredible.
Advocate on toast.
Next question, you're ready?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Sorry. It's over to one of our finest British exports, it's Simon Pegg.
Hello, Jimmy. As you know, I am a big fan of horror movies, but what memorable television moment was described this year as an unseemly spectacle, a scene from The Exorcist, or like a posh version of Alien?
Simon Pegg there.
Yeah, yeah. Do you?
Yeah, I do know.
How do you know that?
Yeah.
Of course David knows that. He was born to know that.
He's
We're
so
definitely strict. Getting a point for this.
We're getting 19 points.
So exciting.
Deal with it!
Right, next question. This year, Britain's Got Talent sparked outrage when it was revealed winning dog, Matisse, had a stunt double for his most impressive trick. What I want to know is, what was the excuse given for using a doggy double?
Double dog.
A double dog.
Which was Richard's rap name in the 90s.
Yeah. It was. And still is today.
To Roland Dorsabell.
The time's not right.
OK. If I did the building, the lead-in, the...
You'll know when the time...
In violent times, you didn't have to tell your soul.
I think the time was right.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Did you just do it?
Yeah.
I was looking down and writing.
Yeah.
Was that it? Well, I'll
you
do it again.
Didn't have to sell your soul. You didn't have to show.
And then he goes low. Yeah.
I will admit, it doesn't sound as close to him as I remember.
You are destroying my confidence.
Oh, no, I'm sorry.
Just build me up a little bit.
You're the greatest rock star in the world. These I can do without. These are the things I can do without these things.
Come
but
on.
But I'm going to talk. Please come on. I'm talking to you.
Yeah.
Come on.
I love this stuff.
After show.
Richard, Greg, you need to write something on why did they use a doggy double. Why?
I don't give a fuck what's
sorry, Greg, what did you just say?
On this particular question, what I said proudly was, I don't give a fuck, Jimmy.
Oh, really?
Why not?
You've got a performing animal, you flip it for another performing animal. As long as they're performing, I don't give a fuck, Jimmy.
Also, I've got to say at this stage, for this answer, I've just written down two dogs. I'm so confused, I've just written down, I think, something you told me.
Yeah. Yes, there were two dogs. Why was the second dog used?
Oh, I don't know that bit.
Another TV question. This Morning with Philip Schofield and Christine Bleakley landed itself in hot water with a rather racy segment at 10:30 in the morning. It received 120 complaints. What was the segment about?
Yeah.
What were they talking about? They got 120 complaints.
Immediately in advance.
Do you know everything?
No, I know some things.
OK, and finally in this round, 21-year-old student Carmel Shah caused uproar among fans after his appearance on University Challenge. What did he do to delight and appall viewers in equal measure?
Oh, yes.
What did he do that caused outrage, right?
Yeah.
That's the question.
You really are nailing the questions. OK, we'll get some answers. So I asked you what Nigella cooked that left viewers distinctly underwhelmed. What did you put?
It was avocado on toast.
Did you get this, Richard, Greg?
Yes, we did. Richard added in swan tears, just for a bit of colour.
Swan tears belong to the Queen, though, don't they?
That's why there were so many complaints.
The avocado on toast, there was more to it than that, because there was chilli in there, there was lemon, there was all sorts,
Yeah, avocado on toast is just the title of the dish.
Just the title, you know. Hamlet is a short title, but there's a lot going on in the play.
OK, you all get points.
Thank you.
OK, next answer. Simon Pegg asked you which TV moment was described as an unseemly spectacle, a scene from The Exorcist, and like a posh version of Alien. What did you think?
Grantham, Lord, not Leslie, ulcer burst.
Well, I mean, I can't fault you on that. Everything's there. And what about you, Claudia David?
He said the Earl of Grantham's ulcer bursting at dinner.
What did you put, Richard Gregg?
Downton character, blood spray, dinner party in brackets.
I think that's enough. I think they've got it.
Thank you, Rob.
Thanks, Rob.
Yes. Well, I'll just check in with Rob if that's the right answer, shall I?
I feel safe with Rob, I've got to say, at this stage. I think Rob's built
I'm
trust.
A safe pair of hands hosting a show, hosting something like this, because I give the benefit of the doubt.
Thank you.
I look for the good in a person.
Exactly.
Are you trying a coup, aren't you? You're going to end hosting. You're trying to get access to the scores.
Yes.
Should we have a look?
It's
pretty...
it's great.
Oh, I'm
yeah, I like
oh,
it.
It's spectacular.
It would really ruin the dinner.
I'm so sorry.
Oh,
sign.
Give me the napkins.
Right, I'll call the ambulance.
Keep him warm. Take my coat.
What is it?
His ulcer has burst.
What? Will he be all right?
We must get him to hospital as quickly as we can.
I'm here, darling. Don't worry, I'm here.
If this is it, just know I have loved you very, very much.
It was a typical bit of Downton Abbey plotting. There was so much build-up of his illness. Oh, I don't feel good. Oh, I don't feel like for weeks and weeks and weeks. Then that happens. Then next week, he's fine.
All right, so that'll be... Yes, you all got points there. Ready for another answer? I asked you what excuse was given for using a different dog in the Britain's Got Talent final. What did you put?
We put that the first dog was ill or frightened, dead or punched a producer.
Jimmy... You can't allow that. You can't allow that.
Oh, no, I can't allow that. What?
What are you doing?
Richard and Greg, what did you have?
What? Rob! You're on... I mean...
Jimmy, please. What do you get, guys?
Thanks, Rob. Thanks for having us on.
Oh, this is some bullshit now.
What did you go for?
Well, Rob, we went... We said two dogs.
Yeah.
The first one had a substance issue and was passive aggressive.
It's a really funny answer, but I can't give you a point for it. Joe and Rob, what did you have? Joe?
We had that dog was scared of heights.
Just
so...
check with Jimmy. Was that the right answer?
Yeah, it was, but you don't get any points because fuck you, dude.
Right answer. The dog did it the first time. What, suddenly scared of heights?
No, they used two dogs in the performance. So one dog did 90% of the performance, and then the last trick, which was walking on the high wire, they used the stunt dog because the original dog was scared of heights.
I haven't been able to concentrate since you did that whole fuck you dude thing. Yeah, well, they genuinely turned me on, Jimmy. Just to see, you're always such a genial host normally, but to see you get all straight into slam Brighton down like that.
God. He
made
was,
me,
in
made
fairness.
Me question everything it did. Fuck you, dude.
Okay, so scared of heights is the right answer. You get a point there.
Thank you. Thank you, Jimmy.
No problem. Thank you. On to our next answer. I asked you what controversial topic this morning covered to land themselves in hot water. What did you think?
It was a bondage thing. It was prompted by the success of 50 Shades of Grey, the film adaptation of the book.
Excellent answer. Richard, Greg, do you get this?
We did, yeah. I saw it. It was repulsive.
Claudia, David, did you get this?
Yes.
David knew it.
Yes.
Bondage, not James Bondage. Nice joke.
Nice humour. Nice joke. I put some exclamation marks around it to make it clear that it's meant in jest.
Let's have a look at Philip and Christine struggling with the ins and outs of bondage.
Yeah.
Oh.
Hello. We have two bejewelled nipple clamps.
Ah, that's what they were. Yeah,
I just nice wonder how decoration. You're going to feel how much grip there is on those. Because for reasons of decency, obviously we don't have a VT for this.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Well, we do have your ears, which is fantastic. Oh my god.
Oh, there's a proper grip on those.
I'll try it, Lily.
You can get these.
What's interesting though is that the woman that had clearly brought in all this bondage gear seemed the most scandalised, using a nipple clamp for the purpose for which it was manufactured.
I tried bondage once. Have you tried it?
No.
Yeah. I was at university, I tied this bloke to his bed. Then I went home for the weekend. It's lovely.
OK, and finally, 21-year-old history student Kamal Shah caused uproar among fans of University Challenge. Why?
He was wearing a leather vest.
Greg, Richard?
A life jacket on top of double denim.
That was our first guess.
And then...
leather vest.
Teamed it with a leather vest.
OK, and you've gone for...?
It was... he wore a leather vest and nothing else on his top.
Let's take a look. There he is, University Challenge in a leather vest. It's kind of not brilliant until you see him next to the guy. Look at that.
You don't know what Smith's wearing on the bottom half.
Yeah. OK, points all round.
Did they get that? didn't get it. Did you get points?
Yes, they got leather vests.
After the double denim.
Yeah.
Fair enough. Okay. Yeah. I can't see, that's the problem. Why they would seat the host here is a mystery.
Let's carry on. Yeah. You got it right. Okay. Now it's time for a special bonus round about films. I'm going to show you pictures from three of the biggest movies this year. They've all been subtly improved. All I want you to do is tell me what the films are. Here is your first one. Now let's have a look at the next one. There you go. Not sure why David will be doing that to me, but I'm telling him no.
Is it?
No, I have no idea.
Okay, and then the next one.
Oh, that's me. Good Lord. That's quite upsetting, isn't it?
Yes, you're right.
Let's get some answers. What did you put? First one?
The Martian.
OK, what did you put?
The Martian. We also put cod liver oil capsule, the movie, because we thought you looked like one.
What did you put?
The Martian.
And then you put train wreck.
Yep. Train wreck.
Train wreck.
Train wreck.
And then Claudia, David?
We didn't know this one, so I sort of guessed Hunger Games thing. But now I can see their answer, and I think they're right and we're wrong.
What did you go for?
I can't read
Mad Max Fury Road.
Fury Road, Jimmy.
It's like an address, isn't it? Mad Max Fury Road, Hastings.
Well, let's have a look and see, shall we? Yes, the Martian there. Train wreck. And, of course, Mad Max, Fury Road. OK, so Rob and Joe get points, Richard, Greg get points. Claudia and David get less points.
Fewer points.
Fewer points, yes. Fewer points. Hey, Jimmy. Hey, Jimmy. This hosting thing, not as easy as it looks, is it?
OK, let's take a look at the scores. So, Rob and Joe have 17, Richard and Greg have 16, Claudia and David have 15.
Oh, fuck!
See you after the break for more Big Fat Quiz!
Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz of the Year. Now, this round is all about what was happening online this year.
I was gone 2 minutes!
Sorry. I wasn't sure you were coming back. I'm sorry.
Really? Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz. This round's all about what happened this year online. On October 21st, the online world celebrated the day Marty McFly and Doc Brown travelled back to the future. It's a great film if you're a fan of movies where mothers try to have sex with their sons. You ready for some Big Fat questions? Of course you are.
Yes.
OK. For our first question, it's over to Hollywood royalty Will Ferrell and Mark Wahlberg.
Hi, Jimmy.
Now, as you know, we are huge sex symbols.
Huge.
This year, a new phrase became popularized, replacing the old faithful, do you want to come back to mine for coffee?
No, thank you.
But what was the phrase?
We've answered all the questions. Now.
We thought we'd do an experiment to see if we can answer all the questions before we hear them.
You're not Darren Brown. What are you?
Well, let's see. Let's see.
I'm pretty sure you're not, but OK, let's see. Next up, why was hashtag Left Shark trending after this year's Super Bowl?
That didn't match up.
I'm not sure that that's clear.
Badly.
No, I'm not sure it is either.
You know what I mean.
Yeah, I know what you mean, but we've discussed it.
For our next question, it's over to musical maestro Josh Groban.
Hey, Jimmy. Now, I love coming to the UK, and I have some incredible memories of some very weird things here. And you and I are both, I think, obsessed with very strange things. Now, this year there was an unbelievable picture of a weasel that was taken by an amateur photographer in Essex. What was the weasel doing?
Yeah, that's hard. Please.
Oh, I don't. Let's not get into specifics.
All right, okay, let's.
Next up,
Shabani, an 18-year-old gorilla from Japan, became an internet sensation this year. What I want to know is, what was so special about him?
How do you spell the name?
S-H-A-B-A-N-I.
I was thinking of another one.
Our mystical guesses are just proving to be hit after hit. It's incredible. I only did it as a cheap joke, but
yeah,
it seems like we've got it.
You got that magic?
Yeah.
All right, final question. Kylie Jenner inspired an online beauty craze this year that involved bottles, shot glasses, and these things. OK, and these.
What?
Is there any food in it?
No.
Is it like you that ping-pong ball thing they do in Thailand?
It is not, but I saw that in Thailand.
Were you entertained?
Oh, well, I beat her. She had a hell of a serve, but really no backhand. All right, so time for some answers. First up, Will Ferrell and Mark Wahlberg asked you what phrase is now used to mean come over to mine for sexy times.
James Joyce.
That was your...
I thought the question would be, who wrote Finnegan's Wake?
Well, you would have been right.
Yeah. I mean, I feel like an idiot.
Yeah, what's your other answer?
Get involved structurally.
So you would say to a lady in a bar,
let's get involved structurally.
That, can I just say, that would totally work for me. I can't now even look at them.
Did you get this, Rob?
We put Netflix and chill.
OK, Claudia, Dave?
That is also what we have written down.
Is that correct?
Yes, that is the right answer.
Yes.
You would say, what are we going to do tonight? Just, you know, Netflix and chill.
Within the last 7 days, my friend of 20 years, Gavin, has invited me round to watch Netflix. Yeah. he's a father of three, and I'm godfather to one of his daughters, but he was saying, do you want to come round to my house and I'll fuck you?
Is that what
you were
saying?
Did he say chill?
No, he didn't mention chill. So presumably, it's not even going to be a relaxing fuck.
Netflix on its own is just House of Cards. It's fine.
It's the and chill,
the chill.
That turns it, that removes the televisual aspect and introduces sexual intercourse.
But that's not how, it's not how I do it. Chill means let's have some noodles.
Yeah, after I've been pounded by by a friend of 20 years.
Yeah. Yeah. I liked it in the old days when people used euphemisms that were a bit gentler, like they said, you know, so I met this guy once, he said, do you want to stay for breakfast, you know? And I went, oh, fuck it, let's have it now. And that was wrong, apparently.
And we're back to James Joyce, who was always playing with language. So...
No points for Richard and Greg.
Thank you.
No points for you, and points for you two, for Netflix and chill.
Well...
OK, next I asked you why hashtag Left Shark was trending this year after the Super Bowl. Did you get it?
Yep.
There was an act, I think it was Katy Perry, and maybe a rapper, and they had dancers dressed as sharks, and one of them danced badly.
Yeah, we've got a little
Katy Perry, backing dancers, shark, out of time, with a fin.
Very complete answer. Richard, Greg, what did you put in your Derren Brown column?
In the mystical column, we put, produced a long sword from his anus. I take it we won't be getting a point.
Not for that. What did you put on the other side?
Katy Perry dropped a ton of offal on stage.
Dropped a ton of offal, is that like a...
No, that is literally... That's what it means. Stop looking for a euphemism. Maybe not a ton, maybe
do you
like
come
five.
Do you want to come round to my flat later and drop a ton of offal on me?
Let's take a look at a grown man dressed as a shark dancing out of time in front of 118 million people.
How do we know that it's not the right one that's getting it wrong?
Yes, the right one might have been adding lots of extra showy moves.
There are only two sharks, as far as I'm aware.
Well, let me just ask, David, how did you get the job
So points for Rob and Joe and Claudia and David. No points for Richard and Greg. Oh. Josh asked you what the weasel was doing in the extraordinary photograph taken in Essex. What did you think?
Flying on woodpecker.
OK, what did you go for, Claudia, David?
We put riding a bird.
OK. Bracket, it was like, oh, is that piggyback? Like,
piggyback.
Those are the right answers. But yeah. What did you go for?
Saying, you fat shit.
Right, and then your other answer is?
Riding a woodpecker.
Well, you all definitely get a point. You may get 2 points because it looks as if he might actually be saying that. Take a look. He's definitely whispering something in his ear.
Perhaps the weasel has misunderstood an offer to come round for Netflix and chill.
Points all round there. Woohoo! Okay. Next up, I asked you what was special about Shabani, the gorilla from Japan.
This is a gorilla in Japan, in a zoo, and people noticed it was quite attractive. And they started taking photos of it, and it became what they call an internet sensation. It went viral.
Richard, Greg, what did you put?
Well, again, interesting how the mystical column can throw up results.
Sounds filthy.
Our answer was the gift of compassion.
OK, and what was your other answer?
Ian Brown impersonator.
Claudia, David?
Handsome, full stop, very full stop.
Well, let's take a look at the little fella, shall we? There he is. I mean, that is a handsome monkey. Let's take another shot. Sure, why not? And then this one, devastating.
Right, he really is, isn't he? He really is genuinely very good looking.
Mm. Yeah, it's a great looking ape. And he became an internet sensation. In Japan, with everyone
like
calling him
any
hot
other
guy.
Rate,
no, but
it?
I don't think he does, Joe.
No,
I think there's something about him.
I don't think it's what he looks like. I think it's the confidence.
It's compassion.
You think it's compassion?
No, I think it's arrogance. It's a touch of arrogance with a fuzzy back, which I love.
Finally, I asked you what online craze was inspired by Kylie Jenner that involved bottles, shot glasses, and these.
Lip plumping.
And what did you put, Greg, Richard?
We
what did you write, sorry?
We put bad dong.
Why did you write bad dong?
In which column did you put bad dong?
It's in the mystical column. I haven't used the word dong since I was 13. So delighted to use it again on the national television.
And then we put giant red face.
Giant red face. Well, you're pretty close. Claudia, David.
Full mouth.
Full mouth. As in, you know,
why are you
full.
Frowning?
As in plump lips, rather than you've got loads of pie in your mouth.
Yes. Yeah. Full mouth. That can often be caused by a bad dong. Okay. So these things were indeed used to for lip plumping. No point for Richard and Greg. Points for Claudia and David and Joe and Rob.
How do I do it? Do you want to go?
As far as I know, I think your top lip goes in that one. I'm not really sure. I think you do that.
And then what?
I don't know. You stick it on your face and then you can kind of pump it up and then you've got to leave it on there 30 seconds, I think, apparently.
You certainly... Your mouth does look different. Immediately.
You look like that gorilla.
Bad dong.
Oh, God, ow!
Did it hurt?
Yeah, it sort of bit me.
Can I ask you, how's the grip?
Well, it's not great. And I wonder whether my beard... This must be a problem a lot of women have. That my beard is preventing the suction from forming.
I'm sorry to hear that.
It's really odd.
How's that?
Yeah, gorgeous. Really attractive.
So some people tried it with shot glasses, which is very dangerous. Don't do that at home. Take a look.
Oh!
Oh, my God.
That's some bad dong right there.
OK, now it's time for the part of the show where I introduce a mystery guest. All you have to do is guess who they are and how they made the news this year. Ladies and gentlemen, our mystery guest.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Very nice
to see you. OK, they're only going to ask yes or no questions.
Are you tonight's mystery guest?
Yes.
Very well answered.
Do you work in entertainment?
No.
Politics?
No.
Fashion?
Not work in it, but it's connected, yes, to. We could give a yes for that.
Connected to fashion?
Yeah.
Did you invent a new item of clothing?
No.
Do you like kung fu movies?
Yes.
Greg, this is not an internet date.
Did you invent a craze?
A craze happened because of you. Yes. I mean, I think you did invent a craze.
Were you personally involved with the craze?
Yes.
Ronnie and Reggie? Is the craze to do with an item of clothing?
Yes.
Right, let's find out what it is.
Is it women's clothing?
Yes.
Dress.
Tennelady.
Dress. Yes. I've got it. Dress.
Okay, you've got to all write it down.
What?
Dress. Write down what you think it is.
We don't know yet. We've just established.
You just said you've got it. Let's just establish what we know. There was a dress, and this year it became very famous. The most famous dress.
You've blown it, Jimmy. You've just given the answer away like cheap rice.
We've got it.
Yeah.
Dress.
Yeah.
Famous.
Okay, write down what you think it is. No more questions.
I don't know.
Oh, yes. That!
That's you, you clever creature.
Okay.
Let's go to Rob and Joe first. What did you get?
We've got insert correct answer.
Can we just look at your faces as Richard and Greg tell you what the answer is?
A blue, blacky, gold dress optical illusion thing. Is it one or...
Oh,
well, tell them who you are and what happened.
Hello, my name is Cecilia Bleasdale.
Hiya.
And I took the picture of that blue and black dress.
We've got the dress here, but if you look at it on the screen, are you looking on the screen?
Yeah.
So look at the screen, what colour do you see?
On the screen, it's gold and white, or taupe
okay,
and white.
OK, so Rob Wright is wrong. Well,
on the screen.
On the screen.
Are you seeing it? So who's seeing it? Who's seeing, Rob, are you seeing?
I'm looking at another photograph of it on the screen. Not you holding it there, but somebody, and it's gold and white.
That is white and gold.
Does that look white and gold to you?
Yes.
Yes.
That looks blue and black.
What does that look like to you?
To me. I mean, to be honest, this is the whole thing about
green and red.
Host, are we all seeing the same thing on the screen?
Did you just call me host?
Yes. With a sense of incredulity as well. Are we seeing the same picture on our screen?
Yes, you are.
Can I come and have a look at David?
Yeah, their screen. You don't believe the screen is
No, I don't. I think they're looking at different ones.
Are both literally looking at the same screen. And she says it's...
That is white and gold.
I say it's blue. This...
You say that's blue and black?
That can't be blue and black.
That's what... Serious?
Yes, honestly.
That's
good God.
I mean, I tell you what, Rob, pop in my brain and have a look.
Serious?
That is
honestly, that looks blue and black.
This is incredible. Well, my respect for you has gone out of the window.
You've
still got it.
You're seeing, everyone sees that as white and gold apart from me.
No, I've never seen white and gold.
This is light blue. With a kind of burnt gold.
Joe, you can't just come
Shall
over
I
and nick
you?
Sweets.
Why Shall not? I tell you?
Oh, yeah, fair enough, you can.
Yes, go on.
What happened was, I went out to look for this outfit. I went into a store. I took three photographs, sent them to my daughter in Scotland, and I said, what do you think? I like the third one. And she said, oh, the white and gold one. I said, no, it's blue and black. And she said, Mum, that set photograph you've sent me is white and gold. And from there, she shared with her friends on Facebook.
What's the science behind it? Have we worked out why it is that we're seeing it differently?
Yes, it's written on the card. And, goes on a bit. Let's leave it. Yeah. Well, thanks so much for coming in. Let's see what that's done to the scores. So, Richard and Greg have 18 points. Claudia and David have 21. But in the lead, Rob and Joe with 22 points. I'm going to slip into something more comfortable. See you in a bit. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz of the Year. The next round is all about the sporting highlights of 2015. Wayne Rooney broke Bobby Charlton's record to become England's all-time top goalscorer with an incredible 50 goals. Wayne will be delighted just as soon as someone can explain to him how many 50 is. There were arrests after allegations of corruption at FIFA. Suspicions were raised when FIFA awarded the World Cup to Qatar, a country so unsuited to hosting a football tournament, it's like holding Miss World in Islamic State.
I think I should point out that it's not Qatar, it's Qatar. Qatar is a build-up of mucus and phlegm. And nobody would want a World Cup there. Qatar, Qatar Airways, Qatar.
All right, I'll do the gag again.
No, don't do it again.
Why not? Why wouldn't I do it again?
Because then I won't have my joke about the pronunciation.
OK. First up, Usain Bolt had another brilliant year, winning 3 golds at the World Athletics Championships in Beijing. But whilst he was celebrating winning the 200 metres, what unfortunate incident occurred? Next question. Controversial boxer Tyson Fury beat Vladimir Klitschko in order to become heavyweight champion of the world. What did he sing to his wife straight after the fight in front of 50,000 people?
Was it, "I'm getting married to Katie Hopkins"?
Or if only.
I'd love that to happen.
Can you repeat the question, please, and go on to say the answer?
Next up, 7-year-old baseball fan Ethan Hall, there he is, made the news this year after his rendition of the Australian national anthem didn't go entirely according to plan. What disrupted his performance? So he was singing the Australian national anthem. It didn't go brilliantly, I've got to be honest with you. Okay. Next up, it's over to pop sensation Ollie Murs.
Hello, Jimmy. As you know, I'm a huge football fan, as is David Cameron, apparently. But what did he get wrong during a speech in Croydon that left football fans rather confused?
I think he's super cute. Edible.
Ollie Murs or David Cameron?
Ollie Murs.
We're all edible. We're... Aren't we? I mean, we're basically meat.
Yeah.
You know, if it really came to it in this studio, it may do in about half an hour, you know. We turn on each other. I think you'll find we're all edible.
Can I vote we kill Greg and eat him? Because there'd be plenty to go round.
Yeah, I second.
It's not a nice meat, it's a fatty meat.
What's this? What meat are we talking about, sorry?
We're discussing who we'd eat first. I mean, it's the ultimate submission, isn't it? There was that guy on the internet wanted to eat someone, that other guy on the internet wanted to be eaten.
Perfect match.
Yeah. They never made a romantic film out of it, though. I don't know.
And finally, it's time for some Say What You See action. I'm going to show you a series of pictures that spell out a sporting story from the year. What is it?
This is enormous fun, by the way. I could do 50 of these.
Yeah, I think the whole quiz should be this.
Yeah.
It's so
fun. I love
fun.
These.
Yeah.
Right, let's get some answers. OK, I asked you what happened to Usain Bolt while celebrating the 200-metre win at the World Championships. What did you all put?
He collided with a photographer or cameraman who was on one of those things that goes around and you have to alter your weight.
A Segway.
A hoverboard-type thing. He was
okay.
on one of those.
What did you put, Claudia, David?
Knocked over by a cameraman on a Segway.
OK, Richard, Greg, I imagine you got this.
He produced a sword from his anus.
You're convinced that's going to come up.
I'm hoping. And then was hit by James Joyce on a Segway.
On a Segway.
Hit by James Joyce on a Segway. Well, I mean, I'm tempted to... Should we take a look? Let's take a look at that moment.
He's a true pro. He checked his camera first.
Did he?
Yeah.
Let's see it again. Let's see if he checks his camera
first. I think he does.
OK. OK, there... Whoa!
Yes, yeah. Checks the camera.
But he may have been checking that the camera hadn't fallen on a small child. Which would show him in a very different light, wouldn't it? He's thinking of public safety first.
Well, he's not thinking very hard of public safety, is he?
OK, yeah. So point all round there. I asked you what song Tyson Fury sang to his wife straight after winning the title fight.
Shout, Tears for Fears.
OK, Richard, Greg, what answer have you given?
Interesting.
Shout. Tears for Fears.
Rob, Joe?
Great track from the 90s from Aerosmith, and it's Don't Miss a Thing, Traffic and Travel next.
The correct answer.
Can I say we also corrected ourselves and put that as the all answer? Day. Don't want to miss a thing.
All day.
Oh, you only bloody did, didn't you?
Yeah. Did you?
You had a little bit of fun with Tears and Fears, and then you went straight for the Aerosmith.
We have the fun, we play the game. We have some fun, then we play the game.
A little more times.
You didn't have to
shout.
Okay, I asked you what disrupted 7-year-old Ethan Hall's rendition of the Australian national anthem. Did you get this?
Yes. He was attacked by Enrique Iglesias' drone.
Rogue drone.
I can tell you that is not correct. Claudia, David?
Yeah. We put hiccups with both of the potential spellings.
We had a bit of a quandary as well as to how to spell it. I went with Joe's advice, meant for hiccups. But look what I did with the S, which is quite sweet. To represent a hiccups.
Yeah.
Oh, isn't that nice? Adorable.
Yeah, P to the power of S.
P to the power of S. Come and have a look, Richard. What do you think?
Oh, that's a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Let's take a look.
Australians, all let us rejoice. Oh, we are we've got all our world. I'm in gold. I see our beauty is
he'd have been in my tutor group, he wouldn't have had a break time free for a year. Wreck my song, mate. Outrageous.
Ollie Mers wanted to know what David Cameron got wrong during his speech that left football fans confused. What did you put?
David Cameron has always professed to support Aston Villa.
Yes.
And the confusion was the kit, because they have similar kits, and he said West Ham by mistake.
That was a bit of ham, doesn't he? Claudia, David, did you get this?
Yes.
Yes. It was which team, he forgot which team he supported. He said West Ham, it's Aston Villa.
It's quite sweet, really, isn't it? Because they're the same colour kit, aren't they? It's quite sweet.
It shows how his mind works clearly, sort of on colours rather than words. Yeah. It's a bit of a, bit of a fucking worry, really, isn't it?
Richard Gregg, did you get this?
Yep.
What have you actually written?
He said West Ham, not Aston Villa or Bad Don. That is the last time that I just can't speak for you, but I won't be saying Bad Don again in the show.
You're right, you cannot speak for me. I can't promise.
Points all round. Finally, I asked you to say what you saw. What did you see?
This was tricky. Great Britain Church snooker spoon.
Snooker?
Snooker.
What are you trying to say?
Have you got a problem with that?
The Welsh people say snooker. It's well known.
We say tooth instead of tooth. We say snooker.
Sorry, Rob, a lot of my relatives are Welsh and they don't say snooker.
They don't talk to you, Greg, so you wouldn't know. But no, the actual thing is Great Britain earns... what do we say
Davis.
For that? Davis Cup victory.
Did you get this? Great
Britain earns Davis Cup victory. Yeah. Although, what is that, the second one?
That's a Brit award. Davis Cup victory.
Well, we got it wrong, then.
Great Britain's Davis Cup victory.
No, we got it...
So Richard and Greg got it absolutely right. Yes. Great Britain's Davis Cup victory.
Now is the time to show leadership, Jimmy. Oh. Now is the time.
Yeah.
Points all round.
Oh, that's a challenge. No, because
I thought you would be making a good decision, but you made a bad dog.
You've allowed
it.
Let's see how you're all doing. So I can tell you that Richard and Greg have 22, Claudia and David have 25. In the lead, Joe and Rob with 27.
Yay.
We'll be back soon with some more quizzing action. See you then. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz of the Year. This round is all about the famous faces that made the news in 2015. Kim and Kanye had another baby. People mocked them for naming it Saint West. But to be fair, Rose and Fred would have been weirder choices. Donald Trump is running for president. This year, Trump insulted Muslims, Londoners, Mexicans, women and the disabled. The only way it could have caused more offence is if he'd fisted the corpse of Cecil the Lion. Some questions about people, everyone. For our first question, it's over to Katie Price.
Hi, Jimmy. Now, I've been in the tabloids wearing some proper risque outfits in my time, but this year, disgraced peer Lord Saul beat me at my own game. He appeared on the front pages of the tabloids after he was secretly filmed getting up to no good. But what unusual outfit was he pictured wearing?
So, Lord Saul was pictured wearing something on the front of the tabloids. What was it? Oh, there he is there. I mean, it wasn't that. That's not the photo they went with for the cover of the tabloids. Which is a shame, because he looks rather lovely there. OK, next question. Shia LaBeouf has had another incredible year. Here he is, motivating the masses.
Do it! Just do it! Don't let your dreams be dreams. What are you waiting for? Do it! Just do it! Yes, you can! Just do it! Stop giving up.
Just do it. Don't give in. Maybe it's difficult and you can't be bothered. Fuck it.
I could see you doing a nice English version of that. Yeah. Would you mind? Would you mind doing it?
Have a pop.
Please do.
Accept failure gracefully.
So the question is, Shia filmed himself doing something for 3 days straight without going to bed. What was it? Next up, what did The Edge, Madonna and Dave Grohl all have in common this year?
Yes.
The Edge, that's Madonna, that's Dave Grohl. They all did something this year. What was it? I think David Mitchell will get this without your help. Thank you very much, Claudia. He really knows what's going on. Next up, we're over to one of the world's finest thespians, Charles Dance, who's reading an extract from a novel of 2015, penned by a much-loved star. What I want to know is, who is the mystery author? Over to you, Charles.
Oh. Eliza and Ezra rolled together into the one giggling snowball of full-figured copulation, screaming and shouting as they playfully bit and pulled at each other in a dangerous and clamorous roller coaster coil of sexually violent rotation, with Eliza's breasts barrel rolled across Ezra's howling mouth and the pained frenzy of his bulbous salutation extenuating his excitement as it whacked and smacked its way into every muscle of Eliza's body, except for the otherwise central zone.
Are you all ready for some answers? Have you all got something?
Yeah, we're all good to go.
Oh, fabulous. OK. So, Katie Price asked you what disgraced peer Lord Saul was pictured wearing on the front of the tabloids. What did you all put? Let's go with you. Claudia, David, what did you say?
Stocking suspenders.
Bra. Not normal clothes.
Not the regular. No. Not a suit.
Rob and Joe, you've gone for?
It's a pink bra, although some people thought it was blue and black.
OK, let's go to Greg and Richard.
We're going for big points in this round. Let's go with the facts. Orange bra, leather jacket, double denim, miniature ankle bracelets.
Well, I can tell you, Richard and Greg have got it absolutely right. Oh, it's an orange bra and leather jacket. Here he is.
Yes.
Wow! What a tool!
So points for Richard and Greg then.
Hooray!
Why wouldn't you? Very well played. Next answer, I asked you what Shia LaBeouf did for 3 days straight. What was it?
He watched all his movies back to back and filmed him watching them, I think, on a live stream.
What did you get, Richard? Greg?
Yeah, watching his own films.
Watching all his films.
You're absolutely right. Points all round. So here he is watching Indiana Jones and the Kingdom of the Crystal Skull. Here he is watching Transformers 1. And here's Transformers 2. All right. Next, I asked you what Madonna, The Edge and Dave Grohl had in common this year.
Did quite a nice job here with the answer. Look what I did. Stage to signify the falling. The letters go down and two arrows.
Nice.
Yeah, that's nice. Yes, nice. It's nice.
It's okay, Richard, Greg, what have you got?
We gave two answers. They fell off stage or they were involved in the Hatton Garden heist.
That's nice. That reminds me of what you said earlier. You're playing the game and you're having some fun.
Yeah.
We all got that right. Why don't we treat ourselves to a little look at Madonna at the Brits suffering a dramatic wardrobe malfunction. You empower me, you make me strong. You'll be up and I could do no wrong. I enter my God. I mean, fair play, she gets up again like a trooper.
Yeah.
What she needs is Velcro.
Velcro.
Yes.
The poor woman's got to undo a double knot one-handed.
I think they've all had so much work done that we don't know how old they really are.
She's not old. I mean, she's 57, but she's got the body of a man half that age. Charles Dance was reading a beautiful passage from a novel that came out this year. Who was the author?
Morrissey.
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 What was
Morrissey.
The name of the book, Richard?
Bad Dong. By Morrissey and Ollie Mears.
Let's go back to Charles to find the answer.
That was an extract taken from List of the Lost by Morrissey. Eliza's breast barrel rolled across Ezra's howling mouth. Hmm. Barrel rolled?
If they barrel rolled, it does suggest they detached. Which would be terrifying, wouldn't it? No matter how much you were in the moment.
Why didn't he just put, they had sex? That's what you need for the story.
I think the word count came into play.
Well, you just then have put in another murder, I don't know. But, you know...
Netflix
they had sex
chill.
And then
they
there was
sex,
another murder.
And then there was another murder. Who did that? They didn't know yet. Let's go and look for some clues, they said, putting their pants on.
David Mitchell, not the writer. The other one. OK, points all round there for Morrissey. Well, now it's time for a very special guest, this year's winner of the Great British Bake Off. It's Nadia Hussein.
I love you. Hi.
Mince pies, did you?
No.
You didn't bake them?
I'm so busy these days, I just employed Mr. Hollywood to make them for me.
Mr. Hollywood? He's more like Mr. Kipling, if I'm absolutely honest.
He's less busy, so, yeah.
Should we have some mince pies? Yeah, let's give everyone a mince pie. Why not?
I didn't make them, by
the way. Can't believe our luck.
So if you have horrible things to say, I don't care.
Thank you very much.
Hello.
Thank you very much.
You're my favourite ever winner.
Oh, thank you.
Can I touch you? Is that weird?
Are you okay?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're very excited that you're here, the winner of Bake Off. I mean, come on. Are you baking now? What are you up to now?
Busy. Really busy. I'm writing a book and, lots of...
David could help you with that. If you get stuck.
Yeah.
Books need short sex scenes and long murders. That's just me.
That's a whole new genre of cookbook.
Nobody's ever tried a whodunit recipe book.
Yeah.
It's a very good idea. So there's a book. What's the book going to be called?
I don't actually have a name yet.
Throw the ingredients together, cook the fucker.
That's what we're having.
OK, you've got a question for us, Dawn. What's the question?
So my favourite pastime is, of course, baking. This year, it was revealed the new Labour leader, Jeremy Corbyn, has a rather unusual hobby. But can you tell me what it is?
OK, write down your answers. What is Jeremy Corbyn's unusual hobby? It's pretty outlandish.
I'm going to have another of these for sugar.
We're loving them. OK, so have we all got something down for this?
Yeah.
Well, what do you all put?
His interest is manhole covers, and specifically, he likes to photograph them if he sees them.
OK. Richard, Greg, did you get this?
Yeah, same thing.
Sorry, the mince pies really seem to have distracted you.
I put years of work into ruining this body. You... tell you what, pie anyone?
Claudia, David, did you get anything?
Yeah.
What do you get?
Yeah. Taking photographs of manhole covers.
Is that the right answer?
It is. Jeremy Corbyn's hobby is taking photos of manhole covers.
Very close to my hobby, which is taking pictures of manholes.
No, all of them. Men's anuses.
Just such a weird hobby.
Do you get their permission?
OK, let's have a quick look and see what that's done to the scores. So, Richard and Greg have 27. Claudia and David have 29. Rob and Joe are in the lead with 31 as we go into the final part of the Big Factor of the Year. Once again, please give up for Nadia, the winner of Bake Off. Welcome back to the final part of the Big Fat Quiz. This round is all about the talking points and water cooler moments that define 2015. The Sun newspaper finally dropped page 3. Women on page 3 are now covered up and do the photo shoot in their bra and pants. It looks like every day they're reporting a story about someone forgetting their PE kit. In October, it was reported eating processed meats was as bad as smoking, which is tough on me, as I've had to switch to salami patches and vaping on an e-sausage. Right, let's have some questions. Take a look at these photos of Hollywood heartthrobs Leonardo DiCaprio, Vin Diesel and Chris Pratt. All of them are sporting 2015's must-have male physique. What was it called?
Oh, yes.
Should be easy. Just look down, Greg.
And,
by any chance, Richard and Greg, have you written bad dong?
I just said to Richard in the last break, I just said, I actually think I've gone through it now and I don't find bad dog funny anymore. But I still do.
Take a look at this footage of Australian politician Barnaby Joyce. My question is simple. What on earth is he talking about?
Start letting movie stars, even though they've been the sexiest man alive twice, to come into our nation, then why don't we just break the laws for everybody? So it's time that Pistol and Boo buggered off back to the United States.
Okay, that was Barnaby Joyce, still clearly upset about missing out on the Sexiest Man Alive title twice. What on earth was he talking about?
Yeah. We know.
Yes!
For our next question, it's over to the culinary wizard, Heston Blumenthal.
Hello, Jimmy. Now, as you know, I'm not the world's greatest shopper. So when I do go shopping, I'm always on the lookout for unusual ingredients. But what new law described by the media as being potentially chaotic could be avoided by purchasing a live fish, an axe, or a handful of loose seeds?
Tax could be avoided by purchasing what?
There was a tax, and you could avoid it if you purchased a live fish, an axe, or a handful of loose seeds.
Oh, you know,
yes.
You are right.
Yes.
Yes, yeah, you've got it.
Move on.
Fine.
And finally, a law passed in 1835 that banned willfully leading or driving any horse, ass, sheep, mule, swine, cattle or carriage of any description or any truck or sled on a footpath led to banning what popular fad this year? Banning fads.
Banning fads.
There's a grown man with a mortgage there. Bad dog.
This could be the first
literally a grown man.
Yeah. It's over.
I've not said a word. I've not said bad dog.
No, but I just...
This joke has got legs like you would not believe. This is like a millipede, this joke. Always.
I genuinely feel like I'm going to go insane. Okay.
All right, so... Okay. I showed you these pictures of Hollywood heartthrobs. Leonardo DiCaprio, Vin Diesel and Chris Pratt sporting the physique of the year. What was it called? I'm going to go to you, Greg Davis. What did you write, Greg?
We thought... Well, it's dad bod, but we did an anagram of it first.
Bad dog. It's a bad dog look. As you can see, they
it's
all...
Bad dog, dad bod.
They've all got bad dong situation
they've got,
here.
They've got dad bods, but they've probably got bad dongs.
Well, what did you put, Joe, Rob?
Dad bod.
Dad bod.
OK, and Claudia,
yeah.
David?
Dad bod.
Well, I can tell you, the answer was bad dong. Bad dong. That was, of course, points all round, dad bod. OK, next I showed you some footage of an Australian MP. What on earth was he talking about?
Johnny Depp's puppies.
Johnny Depp's dogs.
let's go to Greg Davis, who's going to tell us what he wrote.
Well, I wrote the second half of this. I wrote Johnny Depp's dogs.
That's not your handwriting.
What was he talking about then?
Jeremy Clarkson's bad dong.
Johnny Depp's dogs is our answer.
OK, let's find out.
The next issue, which is a gentleman by the name of John Christopher Depp, 51 years old, otherwise AKA Jack Sparrow. And he has decided to bring to our nation two dogs without actually getting the proper certification and the proper permits required.
So the answer was yes, Johnny Depp's dogs, Pistol and Boo, who'd been smuggled into Australia illegally. For our next question, Heston wanted to know what tax could be avoided by buying a live fish, an axe or a handful of loose seeds. We go straight to Richard Iowardi and Greg. Greg?
It was the 5p back charge.
Otherwise known as the bad dong tax.
The bad dong tax. 5p. It's the back charge, Jimmy. 5p.
But if you buy seeds or an axe or fresh fish, you get a bag.
You get a bag for free. Rob, Joe?
Carrier bag tax.
You're all absolutely right. It was the 5p charge for carrier bags. OK, next I asked you what popular fad was banned this year after a law from 1835 was invoked. What did you think it was?
It was the swegway. Segway or swegway. You're not allowed to ride them in public places.
The swegway is yes. Absolutely right. Did
Segway
you get...
Segway slash hoverboard. We
OK,
put.
And Richard and Greg, did you get it?
No, we got Netflix and chill, bad dong. So sorry to everybody involved in the last part of this show.
I regret nothing.
Okay, so points there for Rob and Joe, points there for Claudia and David, and no points for the Netflix and chill bad donging. Let's take a look at the scores. I can tell you that Richard Iowardi and Greg Davis have 30 points, Claudia Winkleman and David Mitchell have 33. Rob and Joe have 35. Final thing we have, the big fat question. I'm looking for three things. There's a point for each, and if you get all three, I'll give you a bonus 5 points.
No. So we're still in the game, despite being so profoundly shit all the way through.
So what I want to know is the highest grossing film in the UK this year, and because Star Wars has only just come out and it's clearly going to be massive, we're not counting Star Wars.
Okay.
So not Star Wars, biggest film in the UK this year.
Got it. Okay.
All right, write it down.
Tick. Mm-hmm.
Next question. The biggest selling album of the year. Couldn't be easier. It's huge. Okay. Biggest selling album of the year. Even David Mitchell will get this.
Already?
I don't know.
I don't know.
And finally, the most watched TV show this year. Most watched TV show.
Oh.
I'm going with Richard's suggestion. Yep. Bang.
Okay. I'm so nervous, I could be sick.
First off, the highest grossing film of the year. Rob, Joe, what did you put?
Is it Spectre?
What did you go for, Richard Gray?
Spectre.
What did you go for, Claudia Same. Davis?
Spectre.
I can tell you, you're all right. That's the highest grossing movie of the year.
Great. Okay.
the biggest album of the year, by some margin, I would add. Rob and Joe?
25 by Adele.
What did you put, Richard, Greg?
I wanted to say 25 by Adele, but unfortunately we had a little bit of bad dong and we've gone for Double X by Ed Sheeran.
Because I feel the Adele album came out quite recently.
What did you go for?
Taylor Swift, 1989.
We actually crossed out Adele, 25.
Adele, 25 was the best-selling album. Most watched TV show of the year, what did you go for, Richard and Greg?
Downton Abbey.
Rob, Joe, what did you put?
The Great British Bake Off.
OK, Claudia, David, what did you go for?
Bake Off.
I can tell you, The Great British Bake Off was the most watched TV show this year. 14 million viewers. So you get 2 points, Claudia, David. Richard and Greg, you get 1 point. And Rob and Joe, you get 3 points, plus five, because you got them all right.
Oh.
That is your last time to add up your scores. Here's how the teams did. Richard and Greg are in third place with 31. Claudia and David have 35. Rob and Joe are the winners with 43 points. Rob and Joe Grant, you are the winners of the Big Fat Quiz of the Year 2015. Big thank you to our amazing panel, all of our special guests, and thanks for watching at home. Don't forget to tune in to the all-new Big Fat Quiz of Everything on the 5th of January, where Richard and I will be joined by Noel Fielding, Jack Whitehall, Mel Gidroich, Chelsea Brady and Jonathan Ross. This has been the Big Fat Quiz of the Year. Good night.